Hi, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to Lenscraft. Today, we're looking at how to create a shadow to add to an image using Photoshop. This image is from my Photoshop layers book, and I frequently get questions about how I created it. If I turn off the layers, you can see that the man and his shadow are separate images on their own layers. I shot the scene in Whitby on the pier around 12 years ago. It's really a composite from two different images shot at different times, although at the same location. To create the composite image, I cut the man out of this image and added him to the background as a new layer. Because there wasn't any direct sun in the original image, the man doesn't have a shadow there. If I turn his shadow off in the new image, you can see that it looks very odd. Our brains can't make sense of the scene because we expect to see a shadow. This is even more obvious because we can see shadows from the railings along the pier. What I need to do is add a realistic shadow of the man. The best way to create a shadow is to use the object that you want to cast the shadow from, which in this case is the man. If I turn off the background layer, you can see that the man is on a transparent layer. This is important because you can then isolate the object to duplicate it, with the copy then becoming the shadow. To create the shadow of the man, I first need to copy him. Now there's a couple of ways I could do this. I could use the rectangular marquee tool to draw a selection around the man. After that, I can choose to create a new layer via copy from the Photoshop menu. This copies the rectangular selection to a new layer. The alternative is to duplicate the layer with the man in it. Now that's fine because in this example, the man is the only object on that layer. Before continuing, I'll rename the new layer to be Shadow. When I click on the Move tool in the Photoshop Tools palette, a box appears around the man to isolate those pixels. This happens because the rest of the image layer is transparent. The way that I'm going to convert the man's shape to a shadow is using the Transform tool in the Photoshop Edit menu. There are several transform options in the menu, but I want to use Distort. This gives enough control to distort the shadow without causing any warping to the area. I can now grab the handles at the top of the box and pull them down to move the shadow. Because I can see the shadows from the railings, I can use them as a guide to help inform the direction of the new shadow. When I have the copy image looking the correct shape and direction to make it appear as a shadow, I can then apply the transform. At this point, the man appears to be jumping in the air because his right foot doesn't meet the shadow. To fix this, I'll zoom into the area so I can see it more clearly. Then I'll use the arrow keys on my keyboard so that I can nudge the shadow up to meet his right foot. Now we need to fix the shadow so that it's black. To do this, I'll add a new levels adjustment and then right click on that layer to create a clipping mask. This clips the levels adjustment to the layer below it in the levels window, which in this example is the shadows layer. When you clip an adjustment layer to another layer, it only affects that layer when you make an adjustment. I can then drag the black level on the left over to the right to turn the shadow completely black. This is now beginning to look more like a shadow, but there's still a few more tweaks we need to make. The first is to reduce the opacity of the layer. Now at this point I'm going to do that to around 40% and then I'll change the blending mode to multiply. This helps to create the shadow effect by making the shape transparent and blending it with the background. Then I'm going to apply a blur to the shadow because the edge of the shape is too hard. If you look at some of the other shadows, you can see that they soften slightly as they get nearer to the camera. This is the effect that I want to reproduce using the blur filter. To do this, I'm going to switch to the quick mask mode and then draw a gradient over the shadow using the gradient tool. I can click at the start of the shadow and drag the gradient out to the other end. When I click the quick mask mode again, I switch back to the regular mode and the gradient's converted to a selection. Now I can apply the blur to the shadow. Notice how the blur increases as the shadow gets nearer to the camera, giving the illusion of depth. Next, I'm going to reuse the selection by converting it to a layer mask, which I want to add to the shadow layer. You should notice that the other shadows are less intense as they get nearer to the camera, and I want the man's shadow to do the same. When I add the mask, it's the opposite of this effect, so I need to invert it using the button in the mask properties window. After that, I can adjust the density of the mask to create a more realistic fading. Now it's just a matter of adjusting the opacity of the shadow to match the other shadows. If the shadow isn't long enough, I can still use the Move tool to resize and even reshape it. It's even possible to reposition both the man and the shadow on the image. I hope you found today's tutorial helpful. If you have, please take a moment to share it with others. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.